Welcome to the third section in our series on lipids, and this section is covering the dietary guidelines for lipids. And it will be a short section because we're just going to go over the guidelines. The recommendation for total fat, and that means all types of fat, saturated, unsaturated, is 20 to 35% of total calories. Now, the recommendation is to minimize the amount of saturated fat that you're consuming. The American Heart Association actually recommends less than 7% of total calories, whereas the DRI recommends less than 10%. Now, remember, the DRI lumps together the saturated fat, solid fats, and added sugars into this 15% range. But I look at it as 5% or less for added sugars and 10% or less for saturated fat. Now, through this class, I'm really emphasizing whole foods, and my emphasis to you is not so much on avoiding focusing on saturated fat as I would focus on a processed fat, limiting processed fats. And trans fats are a really good example of a processed fat. But any sort of vegetable oil, processed vegetable oil, or saturated fat that's been hydrogenated that you see on a package or a label, that's a highly processed fat, and those are the ones you really want to avoid. If you're a meat eater and you are eating meat and there's marbling within the meat, that saturated fat may not be as bad for you, say, as a hydrogenated fat that's coming in a packaged or processed food. So my emphasis always is to certainly follow the guidelines, but be more aware about the types of fats that you're eating that are whole foods versus processed foods. Trans fats, there's really no reason to have trans fats in your diet. Man-made trans fats, trans fats do occur in nature to a very small extent, but most of the trans fats in our diet are coming from processed foods and from a process called hydrogenation, which we'll get into in a minute. On the next section. The linolenic acid and the linoleic acid are our two essential fatty acids. The linolenic acid is omega-3 and the linoleic is omega-6 fatty acid. The recommendation is about 1% of total calories for your linolenic and 5 to 10% of total calories for your linoleic. I want to say that's a little bit of a minimum. One of the problems in today's society that is theorized is that we're getting way too many of these omega-6 fatty acids, linoleic, and we'll talk about these, but they're coming from processed foods. You'll see these are all the processed vegetable oils, the safflower oil and the corn oils and the soybean oil. These we have way too many of, and the omega-3 fatty acids the linolenic acid comes in plant food, so that's what you'll get from walnuts or flaxseed. Your DHA and EPA are omega-3 fatty acids that are not essential to the diet because they are made by the body, but they're synthesized from this linolenic acid, or you can get them from the diet yourself. So any nutrient that the body can make, we don't call it essential. And that's why EPA and DHA aren't really classified as essential amino acids. I'm sorry, essential fatty acids. But linolenic and linoleic are. With the diet today being more omega-6 than omega-3, and generally it's about a 10 to 1, you'll see if you actually ate 10% of your linoleic and 1% of your linolenic acid, you would actually have a 10 to 1 ratio. And it's theorized, I'm saying it's just theorized, that it should be closer to 1 to 1, or maybe even about 3 to 1 with omega-6 to omega-3 fatty acids. So really boosting the omega-3 fatty acids and limiting the omega-6 fatty acids. The omega-3 fatty acids generally come from sources such, the EPA, DHA from our fish sources, but omega-6, as I said, mostly from vegetable oils, which a whole vegetable oil is one thing, and sometimes that even can be a little bit problematic, but most of individuals are getting it from the processed packaged food which has a processed vegetable oil. So processed vegetable oil is not good for you in any way, shape, or form. So when you go to your diet study and you see that, you see where you're getting your omega-6 fatty acids, if it's coming from processed food, it's not a good source. The reason is that when it goes through all that processing, it's not going to have the same health benefits as it would if it was coming from a whole food. We'll also talk about refined oils in a little bit later too. Lastly is cholesterol. Cholesterol is a sterol. It is essential to us, but it is not necessarily essential to our diet because we can make it. So it's essential for a lot of functions. But we want to keep it less than 300 milligrams. That is the recommendation. But trying to always eat cholesterol-free foods isn't necessarily something that's essential. The cholesterol is only found in animal foods. It is not found in plant foods. So you'd only be obtaining, if you're a vegetarian, a vegan, you're not going to be eating any cholesterol at all. And this is the end of our section on dietary guidelines.